Okie dokie. In this video, we are taking a look at working with mutations in Graph CMS. This example is available on the Graph CMS examples repo over on GitHub. I'm going to download this manually with npx digit. I'll paste that command into my terminal and wait for it to download. Cd into the project directory and open up VS Code. Before we take a look around the project, however, I'm going to install the dependencies with yarn. And while that's installing, we'll take a look around the project here. So we have a component for products. We've got a serverless function here, upvote, and we have the index page. Let's take a look at components first. Here we're using SWR, stale while revalidate. We're using the data mutate function from this. This is our key and our fetcher and our options here. Then we're defining a handle click function here for our button. This is incrementing the product's vote here by one. Then we're using mutate here from SWR. And then we're awaiting the response from our API upvote serverless function here. And then waiting for the return on the body. And here we are rendering out the button with the click handler and the product name. Let's go on over to the index. We're importing the product. We're using request from GraphQL request. We're using getStaticProps here to structure in our products from the e-commerce example project over on Graph CMS. We're getting the ID and the name. And we're returning those props to our index function here. Then we are mapping over each product in products for the component here. Lastly, let's take a look at the upvote. We're defining our GraphQL client. And here, this is for the e-commerce example endpoint again. We're passing in our mutation token for Graph CMS. Then here, we're creating our vote for the product. And then here, we're publishing the vote for the product. And then we're defining our 201 status with the create vote ID. Okay, let's take a look at this in action now. I'm going to need to get a Graph CMS mutation token. I'll rename the env file here from env.sample just to env. And I'll go over to the Graph CMS e-commerce example project, go down to the settings, permanent auth tokens, and create a new token. I have content from stage draft. And check the mutations here. Let's create that token. And here we'll see the token. I'm going to copy that, paste it into my env file, save that, and then spin up the project with yarn dev. I'll go over to localhost. You can see we've got the titles and the buttons for each product. Cap doesn't have any upvotes. Let's hit a couple here. Now, if I go over to my Graph CMS project, all the content, go to vote, and here if I filter for created at, we'll have it greater than, and we'll set yesterday's date. We'll query for that. And here we can see we have the 10 items I've just added to here. If we hit refresh, still got the items here. I could go into the content, vote again, and create another item for the cap again. Cap. Save and publish that. If we go over to localhost and hit refresh, we're now at 11 votes. Okay, that's it for this one. I hope you found it useful, and I'll see you in the next one. Thanks a lot. Bye-bye.